Hey, what's up y'all? Quentin here with Catfish Karma, and in today's video, I'm fishing with homemade fishing rods and nothing else. Let's do this!
Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way.
This production is being brought to you by Battery Outfitters, with locations all over the Mid-South. They are your neighborhood battery store.
That was a nice take down. Look at that. He didn't screw around with that one. Instantly pulled it down and taken drag. Brand new home built rod. Can you believe that? Never been in the water before. And we got a drag screamer. All right. Woo! Oh my goodness. I was just about to shoot the intro for this video. After getting these rods out, you know, just kind of thinking about what to say, talking about the fact that I would be fishing with home-built rods. And this one interrupted me. I'm happy about it, too. I think it has turned and is swimming with the current now. No idea what it is. Typically you can tell. This one bit kind of like a blue. Oh, that feels nice. I built this rod. You guys can build this rod. Oh, it's taking drag again. I love it. I was planning on turning the rod so you guys could see how that line is laying through the guides, and I got a nice even load spread there. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe when he gets up under the boat you'll be able to see it. This rod has blueprints for it on the manufacturer's website to help you learn how to space the guides, and I went pretty close to that, but I did fudge a little based on the way I thought it needed to be for what I was going to do with it. And it looks perfect. Look at that. Can you guys see it? That brand new line on there should show up. Better get over here and grab my net. This is going to be a nice fish. Woo! It's pulling. My goodness, that looks good too. Look at that blank. This rod has a pretty soft tip and a whole lot of backbone. I was, and I guess you could still say I am, a little bit concerned about how much weight I'll be able to cast with it. Golly. But in this case, I did cast 8 ounces and it was great. That's typically what I cast with, is 8 ounces. This rod's not technically rated for that, but it's what I'm going to do with it. And at some point today, I'm going to overwork it. I'm going to put a lot of weight on it. Look at that. That is nice. There's quite a bit of current here, and for all I know, this fish might not be that big. He may just be really using the current to his favor, but it sure pulled drag like a good one at first. Although I joke with my buddy James all the time that the ones that pull drag instantly, they all weigh 27 pounds. I've even called it before. Fish is biting, pulling drag. Hey, that's 27 pounds. Bring it in, it's 27 pounds.
This production is being brought to you by Battery Outfitters. With locations all over the Mid-South, they are your neighborhood battery store.
I just have four rods today that I built. Actually, I got five. I got a bumping rod too. But I'm going to be fishing with four homemade anchoring rods today. And if I do some bumping, that's a homemade rod too. But you guys have seen that. All these anchoring rods are new though. I've only fished with one of these anchoring rods and I haven't fished with it in a video. I'm loving this one. This is a 7'10" rod. I would classify it as a medium heavy. I'll probably call it a medium, but it does measure up to most medium heavies when you do deflection testing. I may have to land this one right at the back of the boat to get a little bit of an eddy. Oh, I love this. Love it, love it, love it. You know what? I think I'm going to bring it to this side of the boat because there is less current over here. That'll help. I don't know if you guys can see, there's a current seam behind the boat because there's a point right in front of the boat about 100 feet or so. You guys see that seam back there? Right there, it's smoother over here, faster out there. So hopefully, if I can keep it over here, I'll have a better chance of landing it. Nice slow movements. That indicates it's not a dink, that's for sure. It ain't no sunfish, if you know what I'm saying. Look at that gorgeous fishing rod. I know, I'm dorky. Total fish nerd. That's nice. Somebody did a nice job on this thing. Come on, fella. Better get that to this side. The thing about being over here is you guys can see, if I get any bites on those other rods, I'm gonna definitely say flathead, the way it just keeps digging down. I don't know, flatheads will fight all the way to the very, very end. Blues, not always, and usually they'll try a bunch of different things, and this one is not. He's just really been digging down. There we go, there he's coming. Yes, gotta get it up just a little bit. Oh, it's a nice flathead, y'all. It is a very nice flathead. Oh, there he goes again. He didn't take it all. He's taking probably 6 feet back. I'm in 15 feet of water. Look like kind of a light colored flathead. Not that orange colored, but sort of like the pale green. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but the river is super muddy right now. We had a huge rise. I think it came up around, I believe 13 or 14 feet in a couple of days. Mostly out of the Missouri River, I believe, all making its way down here. The river is still full of trees, refrigerators, you name it. It's all coming down the river. I'm actually off of the main river right now. The main river's about a half mile from here. So I'm in a secondary channel. Whew! That's actually an island right there. It's not the mainland. All right, here we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a good one. Yes! Woo! Yes! Yes! The first fish on this new rod. Oh, I needed it. I've been off the water for like at least 3 weeks. And if you follow this channel, you know that that's a long time for me. I want to be out here 2-3 days a week if I can. To be gone for 3 weeks is not cool. Hey, look at that. I was wrong. I accidentally put a 10-ounce sinker on that rod. So yeah, that tip is going to hold up because it felt like about an 8-ouncer when I casted it. While I'm at this, I want to give you guys a fish care tip. I want to handle these fish as little as possible in this process. So I'm not going to take it out of the net right now because I want to weigh it. And it's a big enough fish that I don't want to weigh it by hanging it by the jaw. So instead of taking it out of the net and showing it to you guys and wallowing it around, I'm going to leave it in the net and weigh it. And most likely only have to pick it up one time to show it to you guys and then straight to the water. I want to spend as little time stressing the fish out as possible. So just leave it in the net. Up business as quickly as possible. Yes. Okay, I know what the weight is, but I want to see if any of y'all can guess it. So I'm not going to say it. I'll put it in the comments later. God, that's a good feeling. I made that rod. And I didn't just like order a kit out of a book or copy what somebody else did. I researched my own blanks. I researched my components and came up with something that worked for me. Check it out, y'all. See that scar? He's been doing it. He's been up in some logs or probably revetment because I'm on some experimental revetment here. But yeah, they get beat up when they're spawning. Woo! I may be over celebrating. I'll probably catch some heck about it, but I don't care. Yes.
Let go, buddy.
Awesome. Woo! Made a mess. All right, I'm gonna show y'all this one before I send it back out there. This is not the one I caught the flathead on. This is the one that I just checked. Got some catalpa worms on there, 6-ounce sinker slide. But the rod, it's a rain shadow blank, just like all these other ones are. They call it a light powered rod with a moderate fast action. But I would say that for most of you out there, if you're using like a big box store catfish rod, this would probably be more like a medium or medium heavy. For my uses, I'm going to call it a light to medium light. I'm going to use it mainly for fishing for fiddlers. You know, anything under 10 pounds, but particularly those real small pan fryers, you know, the ones you cook up whole. And today I'm just experimenting with it. I'm going to throw a lot of weight on it and see what it will handle, what it might not handle. Check out what I did with the reel seat. It's a composite reel seat, but if you'll notice, I've got an aluminum lock nut here. It's just a good, sturdy composite reel seat with a trigger. And I don't have problems with composite reel seats coming loose, but these aluminum lock nuts are cheap enough and they kind of add a little bit of bling. Like, I could have done this in various colors, but in this case, the theme of the rod is black on black, so I went with black. But yeah, I got an aluminum lock seat, lock nut. You don't see that on very many composite reel seats. Just, you know, rain shadow decal there. You can see I got the whole black on black theme going. Yeah, I'm still new to wrapping guides and finishing guides, but so far they're coming out well. I'm proud of them, I guess you could say. These are Alps guides. These are their medium heavy XN guides. certainly enough for this rod. I tend to go up a size on my guides a little bit just to tolerate the abuse that I'm going to put them through on a catfish boat. So let me chuck this out there and see if we can get bit. Vallejo cut bait, 8 ounces, sinker slide. This, while I, you know, it's still a rain shadow blank. It's a completely different blank than the last one I just showed you. It's in that, I would say, medium range. It's a RCKJB blank. This is the one that is a thinner diameter with a thicker wall. And this one is not just an e-glass blank. This one has actually got quite a bit of graphite in it. And I believe the way it works out is it's got mostly graphite, basically from the butt to about two-thirds of the way down the rod, and then it tapers off to mostly glass. I could be wrong about that, but maybe the people from Rain Shadow can tune in here in the comments if I am wrong. But yeah, so it's a pretty lightweight blank because of the graphite. It's a super durable blank because of how thick the walls are, even though it's thinner. Same deal as before. It's got the medium heavy XN guides on it from Alps. This one does not have the aluminum lock nut simply because I hadn't thought of using one of those when I built this rod. This was, I think, the second anchoring rod I built. Something along that line. But let me send it out there and try to get bit. All right, y'all, I moved down about, say, 250 feet, but there's less current down here, and the wind is picking up, so I'm not going to be able to fish down here effectively out there on the anchor rope. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to beach the boat and try my luck that way. It's the only way. Only way that I'm going to be able to keep the boat really solid and still, and that's what I like. So I'm just going to push the nose up and then put the talons down. Hopefully hold right here and catch a couple more fish. All right, before I chunk this one out there, I'm going to show it to you. I guess I don't think I did that earlier. Maybe I did, I don't know. This is the one I caught the flathead on earlier. It's going to have a chunk of skipjack. It's got 8 ounces on it now. It's another one of the SWB blanks. So it's a really fat diameter and not so thick on the wall thickness. It's got a 20 size reel seat with a trigger. It's got another one of the aluminum lock nuts on it. One of the big differences between this one and all the other rods that I'm using is it has the heavy XN guides. So I think they're rated at like, I don't know, like 130 pound line or 150 pound line. So overkill, but I chose them because the frame is so robust. I feel like they're going to be better about, you know, they're going to hold up to getting stepped on and smacked around, and they're going to get abused. And so I wanted to try out this heavier frame size, and so far it doesn't appear to have an adverse effect on the blank. So I'm happy with that choice so far. We chunk this out there. Maybe we'll catch a couple more.
If you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is, to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question: what do I desire?